It's AumSum time! Whoa, whoa, whoa! I was just going to get a temporary tattoo on my face. Wow! Here, I can see the concept of fractions. By making radials, the spider divides the web into equal parts. There are 12 parts in total. Each part is one out of the total parts, or whole. That is, 12. So, we can represent it like this. Such a number is called a fraction. Looking good, dude. Whoa, what happened? My body looks all right, but the face looks gigantic. Whoa, did I just use proportion? On comparing my body to its mirror image, it matches in the ratio 1:1. But my head looks double in the mirror. In other words, in the ratio 1:2. As these two ratios are not equal, I look out of proportion. Thus, when two ratios are equal, we say that they are in proportion. Hold on, guys. You're too short, Tony. Jack must be at least 20 times taller than you. Now, in this case, our brain automatically compared in terms of how many times. Mathematically, how many times is called ratio. If Jack's height is 20 feet and Tony's height is 1 foot, dividing them, we get 20. Their heights are in the ratio 20:1. Thus, ratio is a division of two quantities of the same kind. Check out my cool biceps. Hi guys, I need you to get my gym bag from the locker. But which locker would that be? Just pointing in this huge list of lockers is not going to help. I need to give you concrete information. So, I am going to use the concept of coordinate geometry. Ha ha ha! AumSum, the great mathematician. My locker is in the 4th row and 6th column. If we imagine this as a plane, we can find the position of the locker with two perpendicular lines, one for the row and one for the column. Now, let's draw a line on the lockers of the 4th row and then on the lockers of the 6th column. The point where the two lines meet is my locker. Oh, I need to enter the missing number. Easy! Don't believe me? This time, the number is 13. How did I know? Squares of 12 and 5 are 144 and 25. Add them to get 169. 169 is the square of 13. That's our missing number. Such groups of numbers where sum of squares of two numbers is equal to square of the third are called Pythagorean triples or triplets. Positive, 0, negative, negative, 0, positive. Confused? Look, dude, math is everywhere. The temperature outside my igloo is negative 27 degrees Celsius, while inside it is 15 degrees Celsius. These numbers, that is, negative 27, 15, and 0, are integers. Integers are a set of numbers which includes natural numbers. They are negatives as well as 0. Fractions and decimals, such as 1 over 12 or 9.2, are not integers. Honey, where's my comb? Honeybees form identical hexagonal cells which are attached to one another. Whoa, do they use math? Identical means the surface area of all cells is the same. Mathematically, it can be calculated using this formula. This is an algebraic expression. They are formed by combining variables and constants using operations of addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Here, 6 and 3 times square root of 3 over 2 are constants, and A and H are variables. Come on, let's race. Just kidding. Wow, beautiful shell. The spiral is increasing in a specific manner. Whoa. Here, I can see the concept of Pythagorean theorem. On dividing the spiral into equal parts and joining them to the center, we get many right triangles. According to the Pythagorean theorem, in a right-angled triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. Oh, the dangerous Bermuda Triangle. I'll cover it with this net and save all the boats. But I only know sides of the triangle. I don't know its height. How will I find the area of net required? Ha ha! Through Heron's formula. Area of a triangle is equal to square root of S times S minus A times S minus B times S minus C, where A, B, and C are sides of the triangle, and S is semi-perimeter, or half the perimeter, which is equal to A plus B plus C over 2. You first.
Huh?
Bah! More. Math is everywhere, dude. This point is a decimal point. And this is a decimal number or decimal. Decimals are fractions written in a special form. For example, 7 over 10 is 0.7, which means 7 parts out of 10. While 15 over 100 is 15 parts out of 100. That is 0.15. Here, the decimal point separates the whole number part and decimal part.